Hello there. In today's episode, I'm going to show you how you can persist the scroll position of an element on your page using Hotwire Turbo. So what are we actually trying to solve? I'm sure you've been on websites where they have that dynamic little sidebar where, it's got a long list of things, and when you scroll on it doesn't actually scroll the content as well, which is really cool. But then you get to click a link and suddenly the thing you clicked isn't there anymore, even though the sidebar's still there, and it's quite like a awkward experience. So that's what we're trying to solve. And it's more common than like, it's a common user like annoyance, I think. And it's a nice bit of polish you can add to your app. Today's like little app, I decided to use Bridgetown to mix it up a bit instead of using Rails, because it's a really nice static site generator and you can use Hotwired with it quite nicely. Let's have a quick look at the code. So I've got like the home page written in Markdown here. I have a layout where I've just used Bootstrap to kind of give us a nice two column layout with the navigation on the left. The nav bar's just like a loop of like those same links 10 times just to give me a nice on page. If I was to quickly go to the CSS styles here, I have Bootstrap again, just extended a couple of themes here just to make it a nice different color. Given it a maximum height of 50 vertical height, which is half the screen. Added a bit of padding, made sure any overflow is scroll. And then I've also, in the JavaScript, I've set up Hotwired by just adding it to the package.json, running yarn, and pulling it in. So that's all quite exciting. So how are we going to solve this? Well, the first thing we're going to do is use a kind of hidden feature of Turbo called data Turbo permanent. So it's a little attribute we add to elements, and what it does is it persists the inner content of that element. Let me kind of show you it in action because it's way better. So I'm just going to copy this to my clipboard. I'm gonna put that on my screen, and I'm gonna go to this nav bar, and I'm just gonna add that attribute in, and I'm also gonna give it an ID because the way it works is it'll look at all the elements with this little attribute, save a reference to it using the ID, and then when the next page is loaded, look for all those references again based on the ID. So I'm just going to call this nav bar. Okay, let's kind of see this in action. So I've got hot reloading here with Bridgetown. That's really cool. So if I scroll, it's not going to save the position, but what it is going to do, so if I change the inner contents of this, so if I change this to hello world and scroll again. Cool. You can see that this text is staying the same now. And if I was to open this in a new tab, it's item two again. So anything that changes within this HTML will be persisted between page loads. It's really nice. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to hook into Turbo's lifecycle events. Specifically, we're going to look at Turbo before render and Turbo render. And what my plan is there is before render runs pretty much right after it has the next page, we're going to save the scroll position here. And then on render, we're just going to go through, find that element, and restore that scroll position to where it needs to be. So let's jump into this here. Kind of started working on this already. I've got a thing called Turbo Scroll. Let's add that in. Okay, got a nice file there. Cool. I'm gonna make an anonymous function to start with. This is just means it's nice and isolated, which is cool. And I'm gonna create a variable to store our scroll positions in between page loads. So scroll position s positions equals that. Okay, and these are triggered as event listeners. So, well, the file offers events on the page. So, what we can do is add an event listener to this. So, I'm just going to do add event listener. And I'm going to call it turbo before render. And we're going to set a little function here. Cool. And I'm going to make another one called render. So, we're going to have a quick look at what this does using the console log. I'm just going to bash that in. And same here, I'm going to quickly change this to be render. I'm just going to see what pops out. So let's have a look at the console. So there you go. You can see before renders triggered, and then you have render. So that's very handy. Okay. So the next thing we're going to do is get all the elements on the page with data turbo permanent. And the way we're going to do this is we're going to do document query select all. And we're just going to drop in a little CSS selector like this. And that's going to give us a list of all the elements with that in there. And we can actually loop through all of these by calling for each little function. And let's call that element. And let's just have a look what that outputs. Okay, there you go. Can now loop through and do stuff with that. So let's quickly drop that into our code. And I'm gonna go here, gonna quickly tidy this up a little bit. I'm gonna just create a new line there and put a line ending there. Okay, cool. So what we want to do here is we want to get the scroll position of this element. So I'm pretty sure if I was to maybe go to zero, that give me the node list. It's scroll top. That will give us the scroll position at the top. If I scroll a little bit, how scrolled is that element? That many pixels. Okay. Right now we have access to that element within here. So I'm going to do scroll position. I'm going to do element.id. That's going to give us the ID of it. And element.scroll top. Cool. So yeah, that worked out quite nicely there. And then to restore it here, I think we could probably just do the same thing, but reverse these two. So let's give that a go. Do that here. And we're just going to swap these over. Cool. Going to quickly mess with the formatting. Let's have a little look at what this is doing. Okay. Boom. Magic, that worked. You can see that's kicking in there. That's fantastic. So that's all we needed to do. And we now have a element where the scroll position here is persisted between page renders. That's phenomenal. Okay. That's us done, I think. Yeah, everything's working as we hoped. I've pushed all the code up to GitHub for today's episode. You can have a nice old look at how I put it together and play around at home. I'll also chuck links to everything I mentioned in the description below, so go have a look at those. Please remember to chuck a comment below. I love reading them. Smash that like button, subscribe, share this, everything. It all helps so much, and I always appreciate it. Other than that, thank you for being here and sticking to the end, and I will see you next week. Cheers.